Hey guys, what's going on? It is Castle Perfect here today, bringing you another Wi-Fi battle here live, coming at you with a match versus EMZ or EMU from Twitter. Once again, I get my battles on Twitter. I ask people if they want to battle, or maybe I just tweet something out and people react to it and they leave their friend codes behind and we start battling and stuff like that. And that's where I get these recordings from. Now, I would thank you guys very much for all the support you guys have been giving me lately. You guys are truly awesome, and I am contemplating those 6,000 subscribers. I feel so honored, and you guys should know that. You guys are very good people. Thank you very much for all the support, and keep it up. Remember to like up this video. If this video gets to 50 plus likes, more live commentated Wi-Fi battles will be coming your way. So, let's go ahead and get started. Like I said, I'm battling EMZ. Today, she's a girl, I believe, because I clicked on her channel and I saw the picture of a woman. So I would assume that she's a girl. So I'm just quickly going to grab my phone and make that picture that I always make to remember the teams that I'm up against. So I've made that picture. Let me just set up my telephone or my phone, my mobile, whatever. All right, so she's got a Ninetales, which kind of tells me this is going to be a Sun team, but at the same time, I'm like, okay, in a Sun team, why would you use a Vaporeon? That wouldn't make sense, and an Excadrill doesn't make sense either. Like, Houndoom would make sense, Venusaur would make sense, but still, she's got a very sturdy team. I would say that her team is kind of defensive. They have a very good defensive core, a combination of Togekiss, Vaporeon, and Venusaur, and I'd say the Mega Evolution of her team would be Houndoom. And that would be like the first time that I get to see a Mega Houndoom, though, which is so amazing. Like, not the first time that I get to see it for real, but just in a battle against me. So I am going to start this battle off with I'm going to start off the battle with Azul, which is going to be Latios, and I'm gonna see what I can do from there. Hopefully things turn out to be great. I do have that Arcanine, though, if I need that fire-type, you know, boost from the Sun, if she indeed goes ahead and, like, set up with a Sun team or something like that. Either way, I'll be good, and let's go ahead and get started. So, sorry if I'm coughing too much, because I don't know what's going on after I recover from being sick. My throat somehow never, like, stops coughing or something, I don't know. It truly feels annoying, but anyways, she's gonna start off with the Ninetales, which absolutely has the hidden ability Draught, which is gonna bring up the Sun, and I'm thinking, I am just gonna go for the Psycho Shock here, because Ninetales has very good special defense, but its defense size, defense side is very frail, in my opinion. So she's gonna go for the Protect to scout out what I'm gonna do. And if I take a look at her team, she's got that Excadrill, which will most likely come in on the predicted Psycho Shock or the Psy Shock, or maybe the Houndoom. That would make sense. I mean, I'm just gonna go for the Draco Meteor now. I just want to do as much damage as I possibly can. I don't really care what she actually switches out into. She might go for the Togekiss as well. But it turns out to be the Houndoom, which is absolutely fine. And I miss my Draco. What? Why do I miss my Draco Meteor just now? What the fuck? That makes no sense. That truly makes no sense, and it messes up my plans right now. Alright. Oh man. That's so annoying. I'm just gonna go for another Draco Meteor. She's possibly going to switch out back again into something else that can predict the that can take the Draco Meteor. Because I truly believe that her Houndoom is going to be her Mecha Evolution. And if that's going to be the case, then she would most likely want to preserve that thing for later, or to bring the thing down, or bring the thing up in a situation where Houndoom can, like, do some damage. So I don't believe she's gonna stay in, and what I do believe she might go out into is gonna be Togekiss or Excadrill. And if she's gonna predict the Draco Meteor, then it's gonna be Togekiss. She's gonna go for the Mega Evolution, though. She's gonna stay in. Houndoom gets a very insane boost on special attack, I believe, and on speed. But I'm still faster, and I'm gonna drop the Draco Meteor on the Houndoom. I'm just gonna go ahead and look out Look up what the speed is of... Oh, Handuma actually goes down to a Draco Meteor. That... Oh my... I feel so bad for you now. Handuma has a max speed of 361. So apparently her Houndoom is not max speed, which is gonna come to bite her in the ass, because had she gotten that max speed, or had that Pokemon had the you know, plus speed nature and max speed, then she would have been able to do some damage. Go for the Dark Pulse or something. So she's gonna bring out the Togekiss right now. And I'm thinking, Fire, Resist, Fairy. So I'm just gonna go out into Flash. So I'm gonna go out into Flash here, the power, and yeah, I'm just gonna see what happens. I'm gonna get an Intimidate off, which I don't think does matter. She's gonna go for the Thunder Wave though, man. Wow, she like paralyzed one of the fastest things on my team. Like, that sucks, man. But I'm glad it is actually going to be Flash that's gonna be paralyzed instead of Latios, because it would really suck. And, okay, so she has the Togekiss, and, she might predict the Flare Blitz, and if she predicts the Flare Blitz, I think she would go out into Vaporeon, so I'm gonna predict the Vaporeon and go for the Wild Charge. And hopefully on this turn, while I go for the Wild Charge, she doesn't... Oh my god, she goes out into this thing! I should have gone for Flare Blitz. No, I should have gone for the Flare Blitz, but I predicted the Vaporeon. And now I'm locked into freaking Wild Charge. Now I'm forced to switch out, though. And I think she's going to be using the Earthquake move. And I'll be fine with that. So I'm going to switch out into TM87. And if she indeed goes for the Earthquake, then I'm just going to predict her again to go for the Iron Head or something else. Maybe Stone Edge. And then switch out into Molly. And then proceed from there. Like, go for an Earthquake, I think. Oh, well, not really, because she would predict that. I mean, I'm just going to set up the Stealth Rocks. Because, like, most Excadrills are always hanging on balloons, so I won't be able to hit it, like, with an Earthquake. So she's kind of taking her time here, thinking what she would do next. And I would take my time as well against something like Arcanine. Because those things can really, really wreck up your team. So I'm gonna switch out into TM87, like predicted, she goes for the Earthquake, which is awesome. And I mean, I could like go for the Substitute right now and change my plans, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna switch, I'm just gonna stick to the original plan. I'm gonna switch out into Molly, predicting like a Stone Edge or maybe a Rock Slide, or maybe an Iron Head for that matter. I just want to take as less damage as possible. And look at Molly being all shiny. She looks... why do I call her she? It's a he. It's a male. It's a male, okay? It has a penis. So... Molly is gonna take basically no damage from the Rock Slide, and I'm going to proceed to go ahead and set up the... Wait a second. I'm just gonna go for the knockoff first. I'm gonna go for the knockoff, because if this thing has, like, Focus Sash or maybe the Air Balloon, it will be knocked off or maybe popped. And if she decides to like switch out into what I would call like Vaporeon, then I'll be knocking like the leftovers on that thing, if it actually is holding a leftover. So once again, I'm in the waiting room, waiting until she makes her move. I'm like kind of fast in making decisions right now. I don't even know why. It's maybe because I'm tired or something and I just want to get this done. But that's not the case, guys. Don't think that I just want to pop do this video here and just get the hell out of here, because I enjoy playing Pokemon quite a bit. It's just that I've been so busy and I've been thinking about life so much lately. It's really, really taking a toll on me right now. So she's gonna go for an Earthquake. She's gonna stay in, which I feel comfortable with. I'm just gonna go for the knockoff here. And oh my god, look at, oh my god, Molly, you look so sweet doing that freaking rollout thing right there, and you know, falling back onto your 4 feet. That was really good. All right, so I'm just gonna go for a I'm gonna go for the Stealth Rocks here, because I think that she's gonna predict an Earthquake now that she does no longer have the Air Balloon. And she might just predict the earthquake and go out into the Togekiss, avoiding all the damage and like proceeding to go for like a Thunder Wave, predicting the switch, or maybe a Flamethrower. I mean, that would make sense. I mean, I would have done the same thing if I was her. So, that is... Damn it! Why am I still coughing? Or coughing. Right. Just drinking a little bit of water and waiting until she makes her move, because there is really nothing else that I can do at this point. I mean, I can... Yeah, she's gonna switch like I predicted. Just like I said, she will predict the earthquake and maybe go out into Togekiss. No, she actually goes out into Venusaur, and she's kind of predict... Like, she's doing things that I don't expect, which is... It's weird, if I think about it. Her Houndoom was the Mega Evolution, so I guess as this Venusaur does not have access to Thick Fat, because I think that, like, the only thing... Or the only Mega... I think the only version of Venusaur gets, like, Thick Fat is gonna be Mega Venusaur, so that's great. that's very good to know, because right now... I am going to switch out into... I'm gonna switch out into Azul. I'm gonna switch out into Azul here, which is gonna be Meladios, and then I'm most likely going to sponge a Energy Ball, maybe take a Lead Seed. Because I don't think she's gonna be going for a Sludge Bomb. That would... Like, if she predicts, like, my switch into Gyarados, of, into Latios, and goes for the Sludge Bomb, that would be... That would be, like... Atrocious. That would be like the best move ever, and I would look like a total idiot. So, well, I wouldn't like really look like an idiot. She would just be looking very good and stuff. So I'm just gonna go for the Psycho of Psyshock right now. I don't know why I always call it Psycho Shock. All right. This game needs to be making progress right now, because quite frankly, we are like 11 minutes or 12 minutes right now into this video, and I've only like taken down one of her Pokemons. I still have all my Pokemons left, which is kind of a wonder. Usually, like, I lose Pokemons like left and right whenever I lose the first one. But in this case, I've been able to like maintain my posture and like get all my Pokemons to still do work, which is great. So, she's still chilling up in there with that Venusaur, and the sun is up. And I don't understand why you would be running Sunny Day on a Venusaur. She's gonna go for the Sleep Out. She's faster, though, because of the crawler feel. She's got the hidden ability of Venusaur that doubles the speed in the sun. Unfortunately, though, because she misses the Sleep Out, I'm gonna be able to fire off a Psyshock and deal super effective damage to the point that where she is going to fall to her knees. So she's gonna lose the Venusaur, which is very unfortunate. I feel sorry for you. But I feel sorry for myself as well. Sometimes these kind of things happen to me, and there's nobody that feels sorry for me. But I feel sorry for you, so... Yeah, there is at least one person that cares. I don't even know what I'm talking about. Okay, so Mr. Latios is just floating up in here. And she's gonna bring out the Vaporeon, which could most likely go for a Ice Beam. And I can go for the Thunderbolt. That's not really like an issue, but... I just want to see if I have better options. I don't have better options. I'm just going to go for the Thunderbolt right now. And then after that, like, sponge a Ice Beam, which she will most likely go for. So the Thunderbolt is going to do quite a lot of damage. It's going to take her down to red. It's going to clearly be a 2-hit KO. She's going to go for the Toxic. Oh, this is going to be so painful, girl. This is going to be so painful, because you only have one possibility right now. Only one. Only one, or you switch out into Excadrill, or you just take another Thunderbolt. That's what it is. And I'm just gonna go for another Thunderbolt. She's most likely going to go for the Protect just to stall out a little bit of toxic damage, but hey, I'm just staying in here. Just gonna go for the Thunderbolt. She's gonna predict the Thunderbolt, and she's gonna go back into Excavalier, or the Excadrill. Sorry, I get those two names mixed always. I don't know why. The Mold Break is gonna be active, and she can hit me with an Earthquake, because Lefiatate is negated when you're facing a Pokemon that has Mold Breaker like Excadrill. So I have Psycho Shock, Thunderbolt, and Draco Meteor and Recover, so I don't have anything to hit this thing with. So I'm switching the hell out of here. Yeah, I'm switching out of here. Absolutely. And I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna go back into Molly. Because, quite frankly, Molly's like the best thing to counter this Excadrill. I can take this thing, or corner this thing to no end. And she's gonna go for the Rock Slide, really not gonna do that much damage. And the Sun is gonna fade one more time. And I feel sorry for you. Alright. So, I can either go for an Earthquake, but she might predict that. So, why do I always think everybody's gonna predict whatever? And, like, at the end of the road, like, nothing ever happens. I'm just gonna go for an Earthquake, I don't care. Maybe she just stays in and doesn't predict it this time. And here I am again, rambling about my opposition predicting me. I just hate it when, like, I know what's going to happen and I don't do anything about it. Like, do you guys have experienced that kind of things? Like, you know exactly what's gonna happen and still you don't do the right move? Because then you think, like, it's gonna be way too obvious. And she does, in fact, predict the Earthquake. Oh, man. That is so bad, and I really want to conserve Molly, because Molly is gonna be so awesome against that Excadrill. It's like the best thing to counter it. So, what do I do? I'm actually going to switch out into Flash. The power, simply because I resist fairy type attacks, and like, Flash is like the most useless Pokemon that I have on my team at this point. I like the most dispendable, because he's paralyzed, and I need all the speed that I can get on a Arcanine, and simply because mine is crippled and already paralyzed, so she might just go for a Thunder Wave predicting a switch or something. So it could work out. I'm gonna get that Intimidate off once again. It doesn't really matter on a special Togekiss, but she's gonna go for a direct Air Slash. That is going to do like 30% damage, which is gonna result in a 3-hit KO, or a 35%, I believe. And I'm actually gonna go for a Flare Blitz. I really don't care at this point. She's gonna go for the Air Slash, doesn't miss, lands the attack, and flinches me. Alright. That's okay. I wasn't, like, really hoping. Well, I wasn't really, like, thinking that Arcanine was able to, like, even get a move off. So, Arcanine going down here. It's really not a big deal, because I really have a couple of things that can take care of the Togekiss. So, I'm kind of wanna... Alright, so it's gonna go for the Thunder Wave, and I have no idea why. She's gonna go for the Thunder Wave, sorry. And I get 40 paralyzed. Right. Thank you. Makes no sense. And right now she's gonna go for the Air Slash. She actually predicted the switch out right there, just because she maybe thought that I wanted to preserve Arcanine for later or something, for priority maybe. But I don't really need Arcanine all that much, so it is what it is. And yeah, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna bring out TM87. I'm gonna taunt her into believing that I just want to attack her, and she's gonna go for the Thunder Wave. But then I'm just gonna go for the Roost. I mean the Substitute, and avoid the Thunder Wave, which is gonna be fantastic. I am faster though, which I knew. And I just hope she goes for the Thunder Wave. She's gonna go for the Dazzling Gleam. Okay. And now I totally regret going out into this Pokemon. Alright, I'm just gonna go for the Brave Bird at this point, because right now I'm just losing my mind. I think I just hope things happen more faster right now. I think that I'm kind of tired in my head for some random reason. I'm just gonna go for the Brave Bird. That's not gonna be able to take down the Togekiss, but it's gonna be... Oh my god, it has Citrus Berry. No. Oh my god, Togekiss, what are you doing? Yeah, I just lost the M87 for absolutely no reason. Well, like, thank you very much. Very good play there, Cassidor. That was really, really bad. I'm gonna go out into Gardevoir now, because I think that it's time to bring on my powerhouse. My Mega Evolution. I'm gonna get Serenic Rays, which is totally awesome. I might get just that special... a special attack drop on the Moonblast. I'm just gonna go for the Moonblast here, and that is going to do, I think, sufficient to the point to where this Pokemon is going to die. I'm just gonna Mega Evolve, because really, Serenigraze, I don't really get any use from it at this point. Like, it's not something huge that I'd say, like, yeah, right now I'm just gonna get a lot of use out of that ability. I'm just like, nah, I'm just gonna make Eiffel over here and get my stats sky high and pretty much do as much damage as I possibly can against the Togekiss, because I really want to take down this thing really fast. It's been there really a long time, so it's about time this thing goes down. But it has a really, really high special defense stat, like 361 max, that's crazy. Not to mention its HP stat is actually very high too. It's actually freaking, I don't know, an egg on steroids, I'd say. Like, it is actually kind of lacking the muscles, it's just floating in the air. Like, Togepi is like the most funny Pokemon. It was like, hatching and like halfway through it was like, nah, fuck it. I'm just gonna stay in this egg and like live like this. And then she, the Pokemon then proceeds to evolve into a bigger egg. And I'm like, wow, you are the laziest Pokemon hands down ever written in this in history. Ever designed, actually. So in comes the Excadrill. And Mold Break is gonna be active. And I'm just gonna go for the Mega Evolution. I know that, I don't think that Moonblast will be able to take down the Excadrill from this point, but it will do a lot of damage, and I truly believe that I can outspeed this thing because I max speed, time it nature. So I'll just stay in and go for another Moonblast and basically just get rid of this thing. And it's funny how I haven't been able to set up the Stealth Rocks yet. Usually I do that really fast, but his team, or her team, sorry, once again, I'm used to like battle male trainers, but she's a girl. But on her team, there is really not really something that is weak to Stealth Rocks at this point, so it's like whatever. She's got a Togekiss, but the thing is almost dying, and I'm pretty sure that a Moonblast can take it down at this point. So she has like two Pokemons left, I believe. The Togekiss and the Vaporeon, which is, by the way, also close to death. So I am looking very good. Alright, no, the Ninetales still lives on, right? She decided to like pretty much get this thing back. Like, I don't remember what happens like in the first like 5 turns. I need to double check my brains. Okay, so can I switch? I mean, I could switch out into Azul, but or Cotton. She might just go for a Protect to scout out again. She's got 3 Pokemons left, I can see. The Vaporeon, the Togekiss, and the Ninetales. So you know what? I'm actually going to go for the Cotton here. I'm going to sacrifice Cotton. I really don't care. I just want to bring in Latios safely. I don't want any damage on the Latios. Because Latios doesn't really have that much HP left. And she's gonna go for the Roar. Wow, really? That's surprising. And Molly comes in. And I'm scared out of my mind because Ninetales gets access to Energy Ball. To Energy Ball, not Energy Ball. Well, whatever. I'm like, whatever right now. I'm just gonna go for the Earthquake. She might... Whoa. I just clicked that move too fast. I knew she'd go into freaking... Oh my god, that's stupid. That was really dumb. And I got Stealth Rocks up, man. I'm just tired. I'm not paying attention to this game. Stealth Rock damage just kicked in right there. Alright, well, fine. I think that Ice Shard will take down this thing and, you know, seal the deal for good. There goes Ice Shard. The Togekiss goes down. It's super effective. And Cyborg finally faints. Now, I think she's going to bring out the Vaporeon. And she has 2 options then. One, she goes for the Wish, and, you know, allows me to kill her with an Earthquake. Or she kills me, and then I can bring out Latios and pretty much seal the deal. Or I can just switch out. What about that? Yeah, I'm just going to go for the Earthquake here. I'm okay with her attacking me with a super effective attack that might kill me. Alright, Skull doesn't kill me. It gets a critical hit, but it doesn't get the burn, which is absolutely awesome. Right now, I'm going to be able to get that Earthquake off. And down goes the Vaporeon, which is great. Oh moly, you are such an awesome Pokemon. You just took down two of her Pokemons. The freaking Vaporeon and the Togekiss. Two of her main Pokemon, because those are the two Pokemon that can take the most hits out of her entire team. Besides the Venusaur. So back comes her last Pokemon, the Ninetales, which she has the energy ball just like I said she would. And it doesn't kill me. It does not kill me. That's so funny. Earthquake. And then the Ninetales is dead. Wow, guys. That's surprising. Moly, you're such a monster. And it's shiny and it's fucking gorgeous and it's amazing. And like 4-0, that's the end of the battle, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'm just gonna record this battle in case like something happens to this live narration. You guys, once again, are so freaking awesome. If you wanna continue to support this series, remember to just click that like button right below this video. It helps out so freaking much. Guys, come on. Alright, so that's gonna be the end of this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Once again, comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.